Hi everybody, it's Dave Aquino with Basecamp Trading, and today's this is the free video for today, January 28th, 2019. So we're looking at the calendar, and basically the big economic event for this week is the FOMC meeting. Now, you also have to remember we have a lot of major economic earnings reports that come out Tuesday night, Wednesday night, Thursday night. But from an economic report standpoint, we're really looking at the FOMC announcement. Now, you remember last year, the Fed increased interest rates four times, evenly spaced out across the entire year. The last one we had was the end of December. Now, after that quarter point increase, there was a lot of discussion, a lot of pronouncements by the Fed that interest rates were fairly neutral. And they were mainly speaking to the point that if the economy starts to slow too much, that they're willing to be patient and decrease the rate of interest rate increases. Now, what we've been seeing over the past 6 to 8 weeks is some indication that the U.S. economy is holding steady. It's still growing, but not at the rate it was before. This partially is due to the trade war with China and also potentially global growth as a whole. Now, in the past week, we've been showing signs from China, not only from their GDP number, but also the fact that multinationals here in the U.S. are warning that they're going to have shortfalls in revenue because of sales in China. Apple did it. Caterpillar did it this morning. And I'm sure by the end of this earnings season, you'll see a lot of that from some multinationals. So with that said, it is highly probable that the Fed will not raise interest rates this time around, okay? Primarily because they just did it last month, primarily because the U.S. economy has not shown growth, actually has shown some weakness, and the global growth model has, especially including China, has substantially become less growth-oriented. So with that said, if the Fed pauses, I think the market will accept it because there is some expectation that the Fed will take its time. This is the first opportunity here in 2019. They're not in a big rush. There's no growth. And we're in the middle of earnings season, and we're showing some weakness in multinational earnings because of global growth. So I think the Fed will be patient, and we'll have to see what happens from here on out. But that's kind of my what I'm suspecting, and I'm looking at this pattern here in SPX. We've since rallied from the low right after Christmas, and we've pulled back into this 2673 level. This is the area where we closed 2017, okay? And you can see the U.S. market actually dipped below that number and actually had a negative return last year in 2018. We've since recovered, and now this area is acting as resistance. And you can see here on the hourly chart, how those daily charts, daily bars have looked. And this is a consolidation pattern between 2673 on the high side and 2620, 2625 on the low side, which is roughly where the 50-day exponential moving average is. So again, I don't necessarily think the Fed is going to move the markets. I think it will be potentially what happens with the major major earnings reports from Apple, Microsoft, Facebook, Amazon this week, and not to mention a large number of other multinationals, but those are the big ones that we play in on a daily basis. So again, looking for no interest rate increase for the Fed, and a kind of a wait and see attitude from which way we break above 2673 or back below 2620, and we'll take it from there. Okay, thanks a lot.